Hey guys, before I start the video, I just wanted to jump on here and give a little disclaimer that obviously we are going through a pandemic right now, and I just wanted to say that this video has been in the making for a few months already. I had filmed this video quite a long time ago, but it wasn't until now that I kind of gathered all of the videos of all of my bridesmaids and my maid of honor. So every single video that you've seen, we were obviously obeying COVID precautions and lockdown and stuff like that. So I just wanted to clarify that in case anybody got confused. So I hope you guys enjoy the video and let's get started. Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to share something really special with you guys. I'm planning a wedding and it is hopefully gonna be in the summer of next year 2022. I have been working hard on making some bridesmaid boxes for my bridesmaids. I'm deciding to have three bridesmaids and one maid of honor, so a bridal party of four. This is obviously my first time doing this. I watched a few videos on YouTube, but I kind of turned towards Pinterest, and when I couldn't find a lot of the things, I was like, YOLO, whatever I think would look cute in it and would be a good gift, I'm gonna do. And also stay on a budget, I'm gonna try and put the prices on the screen. I definitely didn't spend too much, but I did personalize a lot of it because I do have a Cricut back there. This is an incomplete box. All the ones that I've given to them, I've wrapped up in a pink bow. So I just have her name written on the box so that I know which box belongs to who. So once you open up the box, that's where I put the cute little graphic that is asking her to be my maid of honor. Obviously on the other ones, they say, will you be my bridesmaid? I put her name here in a really pretty cursive font that I just made with my Cricut. I am packaging them up with some pink tissue paper. I couldn't find any white shredded paper or like filler paper, but I did find like pink. This is a little too bright pink for my taste. The first thing that I picked up is this bottle of sake. It's just really pretty. It was the only small mini pink alcohol beverage that I could find at LCBO. I was looking for rosé wine in like those small little pink ones, but they did not have it, and I've been to like three LCBOs and they were like, no, we don't carry this. So Pinterest lied to me, I guess. Anyway, this is the Sayuri Nigori Sake. I hope I'm saying that right. Don't know how it tastes. I don't drink alcohol. Pretty sure none of them really drink alcohol that much or have had sake. So this is mainly like 99% for the aesthetics. I also picked up some, I think this was like a 5-pack of satin or silk scrunchies. I literally have mine. So I have four girls in my bridal party and this one came with five. So I was like, well, perfect. I'm gonna take the fifth one for myself. And literally, since the day that I got it, I have not stopped wearing it. It just makes my hair feel so good, non-sponsored, but I picked this up from well.ca. I think it was around $10 or $11 for a pack of five, and it's by the brand Kitsch. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm gonna just put it on the screen. Go get it if you want it. I kind of made their own little tags. I personalized them. I did cut out little stickers of their names here. And in my own writing, I put, I can't tie the knot without you, and a cute little gold heart sticker. I just picked up like these little flower things from Michael's. I think these were like a pack of four for $2. Or was it a pack of two for, I don't know. It was like a pack of two for a dollar or something like that. It was super cheap, but I just thought it was so cute to put in it. It serves no purpose. They don't really need it. But the next thing that I picked up was this jar of honey. It's by the brand Drizzle, and I specifically picked out the white honey. I read the reviews and I heard that this one tasted really good. Also, my theme is pink, white, and gold. So I was like, oh, white honey, perfect. Even though regular honey is like golden, so. Anyway, I also personalized it by taking some vinyl and cutting out a circle with their initial weeded out. So like the jar itself, like the top on the jar is black, and then I used the pink vinyl just to kind of like, you know, make it cute. The next thing I picked up was this hand cream. I bought a bunch of them from Costco. I think it was like a 5-pack from Costco, I want to say, and I think it was like 10 bucks. And I even got one for myself, so this is just the one that I put in here. I think there was two pinks, two purples, and then one tan one. So I just kept the tan one for myself. I also picked up a bunch of EOS lip balms. I also bought them from Costco. I believe it was a package of 8 for $15. So I just put 2 in each girl's box, and these are the 2 that I chose for her. They were all pretty much random. And then the last thing that I'm including is this little mirror that I personalized with their initial with like gold sparkly vinyl. And I just think it's so cute. The mirror itself is so inexpensive. I think it was like $1 or $2, maybe $2. Ooh, I'm looking a little crusty. Oh yeah, I look crusty for sure. So that is everything in the box. I know it's not a lot, but I don't feel like, I don't know, are you supposed to put a lot? So I'm going to dress it up now so I can show you guys how I pack it. So before I sticker close it, oh, I hope these don't fall, but this is generally how it looks. I put the little scrunchie on top so that they can see that their name is there. So it says, Gail, I can't tie the knot without you. And then it'll have the scrunchie there on top of everything. Oh. There are a few things that I didn't include in the breakdown of the cost because I already had these things on hand, like the white box that I packaged everything in. They were originally $4 or $5, I think, but I got them from a store that was actually going out of business. So I only paid 50 cents each box, and I bought them years ago before I even got engaged. I bought them specifically for this moment. I already had the stickers and the vinyl for all the crafting stuff. I bought the filler paper from Walmart for 88 cents per bag, and I'm pretty sure I only used 1 or 2 bags. And I did buy the ribbon from Michaels. It was on sale for $4 for the roll. So anyway, that is my bridesmaid box. It was super simple to make, and it was a lot of fun to do, especially just to personalize it. Like, it doesn't take much to personalize if you already have like a Cricut or something like that. But even if you don't, you can always go out and buy stickers of just like letter stickers and stuff. And it's just a lot of fun to personalize it. And I actually did grab a few videos of when I gave my bridesmaids their boxes. So I will put them in if they let me.
Okay. I have something for you.
That's for me?
That's for you.
Wait, I'm gonna be a bridesmaid.
Open it up, bitch.
Okay. Fiona, will you be my bridesmaid? I don't want to cry. Of course. Yes.
Oh my gosh. This is so nice. You'll be.
Oh. Yes.
Yes. This is yours.
What is this?
Oh my god, this is so cute.
No, I don't want to open it.
You have to.
No,
you have to. You gotta check the.
Yeah!
Yeah! Yay!
Oh my god, I'm so excited!
I'm nervous. What is it?
Don't be nervous. Just open it.
I want like a sugarless cream simply.
I don't know what to do.
I'm gonna love what we have.
Yeah, it was just super special because it didn't cost a lot, but it definitely made them feel special. So that's, I wanted them to feel special for my special time because they're special to me and we're just all special together. And that is it for this video. Thank you guys so much for popping in and staying and just chilling with me. If you guys are curious as to what I'm up to and, you know, anything like that, I am on Instagram at the same handle, @thatlinguistic. And until next time, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.